Dear students, in the previous lecture, we have seen about the bidirectional replication or theta structure of replication that commonly takes place there in the circular DNA molecule. Whereas here, in this lecture, we are going to see the other form of replication, that is rolling circle replication or sigma replication. It is referred as sigma replication due to the reason some molecular structures that are formed during the replication are resembling to that of the Greek symbol sigma. The rolling circle replication is actually a unidirectional replication process of the nucleic acid. In this process, the rapidly synthesized multiple copies of the circular molecules, mainly by using DNA or RNA as a templates, and this kind of a rolling circle replication commonly takes place in the plasmids, the genomes of bacteriophages, and the circular RNA genome of certain viroids. Apart from that, they also takes place in certain specific eukaryotic viruses such as human papilloma virus. This virus is basically a DNA virus which causes the cervical cancer there in the females. Next, we look at into the mechanism of the rolling circle replication. In this mechanism, the double stranded circular DNA molecule replicates by first starting a nicking, that is a cut has been caused there in the double stranded DNA molecule, and unrolling of one strand fully, whereas the other strand is used as a template strand for the DNA synthesis. So the steps that have been involved there in the rolling circle replication have been shown clearly in this diagram. So if you look at the replication form of DNA is nicked or cut with the help of an enzyme protein or by a gene protein, and then it is subjected for a new plus strand that begins to synthesize there. That is the growing point of the strand has been shown there in the green color, and then it further extends, that is continued extension of the original plus strand of the organism has been subjected for synthesis of a new plus strand. One revolution of replication completed and only one progeny virus genome has been made there. Further, it has been cleaved and ligated by the same gene A protein. That results in the formation of one bacteriophage genome. This is the replication is taking place there in the bacteriophage genome. So, one bacteriophage genome, that is X174 refers to the genome of the bacteriophage. So one bacteriophage genome of a plus strand that made up of a single strand DNA has been synthesized. The original replicative form will be ready for further new genome synthesis process. This single stranded DNA is further subjected by DNA polymerase and RNA polymerase enzyme to form into a double stranded DNA molecule. Look at this image. This reveals how the lambda phage DNA is replicated and that has been packed there further for the other course of infection. So this whole structure is a bacteria. This has been attached by a lambda phage. So lambda phage refers to a phage which attacks a particular bacteria. There you can able to see the host chromosome. Then you can able to see how the viral DNA that has been entered there, it has been injected there, is undergoing the two process of replication which we have earlier discussed. One is the bidirectional replication or theta replication, and another one is a unidirectional replication which we have just now seen, that is a rolling circle replication. So after the rolling circle replication, the particular DNA is again packed there into the head region of the lambda phage, and it will again lyse that particular bacteria. It will be ready to infect the new bacteria. So this diagram depicts the presence of two different kinds of replication that have been taking place there inside a lambda phage affected bacterial cell. Next, we look at into how certain linear nucleic acid molecules are synthesized. Here, linear viral DNA molecules will usually have a single origin of replication However, that particular replication may not be necessarily present in the center of the molecule as that we have seen in the bacterial bidirectional replication. Apart from that, there are other linear DNA molecule containing important organisms or eukaryotes. In both these cases, the origin is a complex region where the initiation of DNA replication and control of the growth cycle of the organisms are usually regulated and tightly coordinated. On comparison with the viral DNA molecule, the eukaryotic DNA molecules are long, linear, and they have been arranged there in the multiple chromosomes of the eukaryote. So automatically they consist of multiple origins of replication. So in the right hand side you can see three origin of replications, and you can able to see the replication bubble also. This replication bubble has been extending. As a result, they will coalesce and finally the two daughter DNA molecules have been synthesized there. So if you look at into a typical mammalian cell, it has more than 50,000 to 1 lakh number of replicons present within a 40 to 200 kb of a genome. So this is the reason why it is referred as a multiple origin of replications will be commonly present there in the linear chromosomes of the eukaryotic cells. During the course of replication, the replication force from an adjacent replication points, that is the replication bubbles, will meet together. They will be coalescing or fusing to form a completely replicated DNA structure. And these are the steps I have narrated. First, second and third are the important steps in which the eukaryotic DNA molecule that are usually linear in structure will be synthesized there in the organisms.